नमस्ते, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर के चौधरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर, एंड सब्जेक्ट इज एनिमल डाइवर्सिटी एंड कंपैरेटिव एनाटॉमी ऑफ द वर्टिब्रेट्स। एंड नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ओरिजिन ऑफ द एम्फीबियंस और द ओरिजिन ऑफ द टेट्रापोड्स। Amphibians were the first group of vertebrates to develop limbs and to be able to leave the water to conquer the land. Even if they are seen as simple and primitive animal by most people, animals show a wide diversity of survival strategy which have allowed them to occupy most terrestrial and freshwater habitats. On this entry, we will explain some of the aspects related to their evolution, explaining how our ancestor managed to get out of the water. पहला ग्रुप है वर्टिब्रेट्स का जिसने के अंदर लिम्स डेवलप हुए, जो वाटर से बाहर निकल कर आया। तो इसके अंदर हम कहेंगे कि भी जो एंसेस्टर हैं वो पानी से बाहर कैसे अपने आप को मैनेज किया, कैसे अपने आप को अडेप्ट किया। तो ओरिजिन ऑफ एम्फीबियन, करंट एम्फीबियंस टुगेदर विद रेप्टाइल्स, बर्ड्स एंड मैमल्स आर फाउंड विद इन द सुपर क्लास टेट्रापोडा। टेट्रापोडा यानी कि इसके फोर लिम्स। द वर्टिब्रेट ग्रुप दैट अबैंडन्ड द सी टू कन्क्वायर द लैंड। दीज First tetrapods were amphibians and they evolved around 395 million years ago during the Devonian period from low-finned fish named Sarcopterygian class Sarcopterygi flesh fin, within which we find the coelacanth and the current lungfish. This group of fish is characterized by its fin, which instead of being formed by rays like in most bony fishes, they have a bony base that allowed the subsequent evolution of the limbs of the first amphibians. Within the Sarcopterygian, the nearest relative of the tetrapods are the osteolepiforms, order osteolepiforms, a group of tetrapodomorph fish that got extinct about 299 million years ago. Then adaptation to live on the land. The conquest of the land was not done from one day to the other. It was possible with a combination of the multiple adaptations. Some of the most important characteristics that allowed the first amphibian फर्स्ट एम्फीबियन टू लीव द वाटर वर, पहला क्या था कि इवोल्यूशन ऑफ द लंग्स विच वर होमोलोगस टू द गैस ब्लेडर दैट अलाउ फिश टू कंट्रोल इट्स बायोन्सी। लंग्स अपीयर एज एन एडिशनल वे टू गेट ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द एयर। इन फैक्ट देर इज एक्चुअल ए Sarcopterygian फैमिली द मेम्बर ऑफ विच हैव लंग्स टू गेट ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द एयर फॉर दे लीव इन वाटर पुअर ऑन ऑक्सीजन। तो सबसे पहले लंग्स का इवोल्यूशन हुआ। देन डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द क्वेनिस और द इंटरनल नोस्ट्रिल्स। वाइल फिश प्रेजेंट ए पेयर ऑफ एक्सटर्नल नोस्ट्रिल्स एट ईच साइड ऑफ इट्स स्नाउट थ्रू विच वाटर पासिस ऑन वाइल स्विमिंग, द एंसेस्टर ऑफ द टेट्रापोड्स ओनली हैड वन एक्सटर्नल नोस्ट्रिल एट ईच साइड कनेक्टेड टू द इंटरनल नोस्ट्रिल। The internal nostril which communicate this allowed them to get air through their nose using lung ventilation and this way to smell outside of water. फिर है apartition of the quadridium like limbs. Quadridium is the tetrapod most basic characteristics. This limb is known for having the differentiated parts. The stylopodium, द वन बोन द ह्यूमरस और द फीमर, द जुगोपोडियम टू बोन्स द रेडियस और टीबिया एंड द अल्ना द फिब्यूला एंड द ऑटोपोडियम फिंगर्स हैंड्स टोज एंड द फिट्स, वाइल द स्टाइलोपोडियम एंड जुगोपोडियम डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द सार्कोप्टर्जियन फिन, द ऑटोपोडियम इज ए न्यूली फिन, द ऑटोपोडियम इज ए न्यूली इवॉल्व स्ट्रक्चर एक्सक्लूसिव फ्रॉम द टेट्रापोड्स. इन शॉर्ट द रिलेटिव्स ऑफ द ऑस्टियोलेप्स ऑफ द टेट्रापोड्स डेवलप द टेट्रापोड्स टिपिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स बिफोर एवर लिविंग वाटर बिकॉज दे प्रोबेबली लिव्ड इन ब्रैकिस शैलो वाटर पुअर इन ऑक्सीजन एंड दैट ड्राइड आउट क्विकली एंड ऑफन. द फर्स्ट एम्फीबियन प्रोबेबली द क्रिएचर नोन एज टिक्टेलिक इज द क्लोजेस्ट एनिमल टू द मिड पॉइंट बिटवीन द ऑस्टियोलेपिफॉर्म्स एंड द एम्फीबियंस. द फर्स्ट रिकॉर्डेड एम्फीबियंस वर लेब्रिंथोडोंट्स, मीनिंग दैट देयर टीथ हैड ए लेयर ऑफ डेंटिन एंड इनेमल फॉर्मिंग ए स्ट्रक्चर सिमिलर टू ए मेज. देयर वर फोर मेन ग्रुप ऑफ प्रिमिटिव एम्फीबियंस, ईच कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाई ए ग्रुप दैट इंक्लूड द फर्स्ट एनिमल दैट वर एबल टू गेट आउट ऑफ द वाटर, ए सेकेंड ग्रुप विच कंटेन द एंसेस्टर ऑफ द एमनियोट्स एंड टू मोर ग्रुप्स बोथ कैंडिडेट टू बी द एंसेस्टर ऑफ मॉडर्न एम्फीबियंस. ऑर्डर Ichthyostegalia. Ichthyostegalians were the first tetrapod to be able to leave the water. Then order Ichthyostegalia. Ichthyostegalians were the first tetrapod to be able to leave the water. They appeared at the late Devonian period and they were big animal with large wide heads, short legs and aquatic and semi-aquatic lifestyles. They move around using mainly their muscular tail with rays similar to that of fishes. Similarly to current amphibians, they presented a lateral line sensory organ that allow fish to detect vibration and movement into the water and were able to breathe through their skin. They lost the cosmid scale of their ancestor. Also, the eggs were laid in the water from which the tadpoles emerged, and later on they suffered a metamorphosis process to become adult just like current amphibians. Subsequently, Ichthyostegalians gave rise to the rest of the amphibian groups. Then clade reptiliomorpha. Reptiliomorphs were the ancestor of amniotes and appeared about 340 million years ago. Most of them were usually large and heavy animals which presented more advanced adaptation to live on land. Even though reptilomorphs still laid their eggs in the water and had larval stage with gills, it would not be until the late Carboniferous period when the first amniotes, animal that could lay their egg on dry land, would emancipate completely from the water. Then order Temnospondyli. This group is one of the possible candidates to being the ancestor of modern amphibians. This is the most diverse group of primitive amphibians and it survived until the early Cretaceous period about 120 million years ago. The Temnospondyles varied greatly in the shape, size and the lifestyle. Most of them were meat eater, but some were terrestrial predator, some were semi-aquatic and some had returned completely to the water to breed for the fertilization, and the fertilization was the external. While the female laying clutch of eggs in the water, the male released the sperm over them. Within the Temnospondyles, we can find some of the biggest amphibians that ever lived, such as Prionosuchus, with an estimated length of 5 meters and about 300 kilograms of weight, Also, even though their skin was not covered with scales, it was not completely smooth like the modern amphibians. It is believed that this group could be sister taxon of the modern amphibians, even though there is one last group which could be a candidate to that post. Order Lepospondyli. Lepospondyles were the small group of primitive animals which appeared at the early Carboniferous and disappeared at the late Permian period. Even though Lepospondyles were not as numerous and smaller than the Tamnospondyles, they presented a wide range of body shape and the adaptation. The first Lepospondyles looked superficially like small lizards, but subsequently lot of groups had process of limb reduction or the loss. The relationship of the Lepospondyles with the rest of the tetrapods is not very clear. Different hypotheses go from some authors arguing that they were a group separated from the labyrinthodonts, some thinking that they were the ancestor of the current amphibians and reptiles, and some even saying that they were the ancestors of only a portion of the modern amphibians. As we can see, the classification of primitive amphibians can be an extremely complex thing. On this entry, I try to make the summary of the most important group of the ancient amphibians, and on the next one, we will center on the evolution of the modern amphibians, so-called Lys amphibians, and we will look in more detail all the controversy surrounding these curious animals. This is all about the origin of the tetrapods or the amphibians. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women University, Jaipur. Hope you understand the topic. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you. Thank you very much.